We are discussing strategy, so let's get right into it. Strategy is a specific plan of action that intentionally takes your organization from its current location, from its current place, or from its current position to its desired goal. Now, Harvard or Harvard Business Review defines strategy as a plan that creates value. Now, both definitions will work. Let me tell you a little about a benefit of having a strategy. When your organization has a strategy, it eliminates the tendency to operate aimlessly. Your decision should lead you and your team only towards your intended destination, right? So you're not wandering around, clueless, not sure where to go. It also costs a big expense if you don't have a specific plan of action. Hello, everyone. I am Dr. M. Stolard, entrepreneurial strategist, cultivating brand clarity for the solopreneurs, the organizational founders, and those who truly want to serve and give back. So let's continue to the second benefit. Benefit number two, a strategy helps to shorten the destination from where you and your organization are starting from, where you want to go. You can end up on a wrong turn without a strategy. If you're just going around aimlessly, well, we're just going to go this direction and see what happens. We're just going to launch this product, right? We're not going to test it. We're not going to do any marketing research. We're just going to see what happens. That costs you time. That costs you money. In some cases, people may lose their job. Strategy has to be purposeful. The best executed strategy is based on purposeful research, intentional research, not just, you know what, let me just go with my gut instinct. Now, I understand that there is some argument with using your gut for the people who've maybe been in a particular industry for 10, 15, 20 years. But even then, they've probably seen some strategies that didn't work, right? So that helps to strengthen their current strategy of today. Next, we're talking about communication. Your organization should have clear communication to your team, to your clients, to your customers about what those expectations are. The expectations, the directions, and the end goals. These are the necessary components for a strategy. And I'll say it again. So when you're talking about communication, your organization, whether it's a small business, right? Whether it's a nonprofit, community organizations should have a clear communication with your team, your client, with your customers about expectations, directions, and end goals. That's the necessary point of having strategic roles. It is necessary that your organizational leadership clearly articulates all the responsibilities. So that's you. If you're the solopreneur, if you're the boss, if you're the one that's founding an organization, it's necessary that you communicate the roles of the people who report to you. Doesn't matter if you have a team of one, doesn't matter if you have a team of three. If you want to have a team of one, articulate what's going to be your role. And if you're going to contract something out, what is going to be their role? Same thing if you have a team of three. You don't want everybody doing the same because that just creates conflict. Now the results. All organizations must track and document the results achieved based on the implemented strategy. So maybe you did have a specific plan of action. You did have a goal that you were trying to reach. You should have measurements along the way on what that actually looks like. You should have measurements along the way on what that actually looks like. So you can actually see if what you're doing actually makes sense. Strategies must constantly improve based on results. So if you're tracking that information plan, if you're tracking the strategy that you implemented in order to launch a particular product, you want to take the measurements and see if it makes sense. And if what were those results or those goals that you wanted to have, and if you actually achieved. Let me give you a few steps on developing a strategy. Determine what the vision or the overall goal is for your company or for your business, right? You should have an overall company as far as the direction that your company's trying to head. If you have a particular product or service, what is the goal? What is the intention? What is the ideal result for that particular product or service? Then determine what is the critical question? What is the critical issue that you want to answer? In other words, what is the problem you want to bring the answer to? What is that for you? What does this particular product or service do for you and for the clients and for your customers? What is that problem? Now that you have the problem, you have to identify how you want to solve it, right? How you want to solve it. And then you're going to determine the direction you want to go to get it done. What's the direction that you want to go when it comes to solving that particular problem? Now you're going to put the plan together and then you're going to execute it. Simple, just a few easy steps. People I typically serve who are, you know, running a small organization or wanting to start a community organization, and maybe they have a team of less than five people, they're feeling this kind of pressure, like they're running out of time. And in most cases, you know, they have a master's degree, maybe they have the MBA, they have their 9-to-5, but they're wanting to do something more. They want to give back. However, one of the biggest challenges I have seen is that they don't have a specific strategy. They don't have a specific strategy for their entrepreneurial endeavors. And they don't have a specific plan of action for that organization that they're on the verge of launching or truly want to. And you know what? They have not taken the time to position themselves for their ideal customer or for the people they truly want to serve. They're just walking around aimlessly, just saying, you know what? I'll just see what works and see what happens. That's not a good plan. In addition, they're not sure how to articulate what it is they do or want to do. And that's where I come in. I help them cultivate brand clarity. I help them to understand and embrace customer sentiment. I help them to develop a specific plan of action or strategy to get them from where they are to where they're trying to go. Help them see better where they're trying to get to so they can create a plan so they can actually get there. It's one thing to actually see the plan in the distance. That's like the first step. Then you got to make a plan to get there. And that's where I come in. Hope this was helpful to you. Please let me know if you have any questions. We'll talk again soon.